So much for tuning in to Forks and Figs' very first installment of Plan Your Dinner. Recently, I realized that a bunch of my friends have come to me and said, how do you plan such fabulous dinner parties? So I decided that I'm going to take my friends with relatively no kitchen experiences and help them go from kitchen clueless to kitchen chic. So Jillian and I have been friends for years and years, and she really has no kitchen experience. Jillian, why don't you tell us a little bit about what I can do for you?
Okay, well, it's Valentine's Day coming up, and I decided that what I want to do for it is, for my boyfriend, is just to cook a nice meal, keep it simple, not cheesy, but I don't know how. And I don't know what to cook.
That's so sweet. I have the perfect solution. Do you know what every guy loves?
What?
Surf and turf.
Oh, good.
We're going to do some spicy shrimp, just really quick flash sauteed. And then we're going to do a beautiful filet mignon. We'll serve it with red wine risotto, which is going to be great because it's going to be pink perfect for Valentine's Day. And then we'll just serve a simple green salad on the side.
You just come up with that on top of your head.
He's going to love it, Jillian. I'm so excited. Let's get to work. Okay, so here we are. We're geared up and ready to go. The first thing we need to start with is our red wine risotto because that is going to take the longest, so you need to get it going. Okay. The proteins are going to be quick, so we're going to get started. Ready?
All right. Yeah.
All right. The first thing I'm going to show you is actually a really good thing to know because you can use it on so many vegetables.
Okay.
So here we have shallots. These are pretty big ones. So what we're going to do, we're just going to take our knife and we're just going to chop off that root end. Okay? Good. Then we're just gonna chop off this end, okay?
Okay.
Now you can probably just kind of grab the peel off like that. Perfect. Now we're gonna make cuts going this way, okay? So we're gonna go boom, 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 okay? All right, so we've got our shallot and we're almost ready for the last cut.
Okay.
We're just gonna take our knife and we're just gonna cut this way. Okay, are you ready to get our risotto going?
Yeah.
So the first thing we need to do is heat up 2 tablespoons of olive oil on medium-high heat in our pot over there.
Do you have a measuring spoon?
Nope, but all you need to do is just pour and say 1 Mississippi and you will have a perfect tablespoon.
Oh, cool.
Yep.
Okay.
Here you go.
1 Mississippi.
Oh, 1 Mississippi. There you go, that's perfect. So now let's add our shallots.
All right.
So that's 2 whole shallots that we're adding.
Ooh, oh, it's gonna sparkle up. Okay,
okay. Perfect.
I love that sound.
Now we've got our spoon here. Let's just give it a little stir. All right, Jillian, so our shallots have softened. It took 4 to 5 minutes, right?
Yeah,
not long
fast.
At all. All right, so then we added our 1.5 cups of risotto.
Okay.
We just wanna toast this up to release the natural oils in the rice. So not long, 5 minutes max. All right, so why don't you stir that?
Okay.
Great. So the whole thing about risotto is that you need to go low and slow. Low heat, slow cooking. That's the idea. We need to add a little bit of stock at a time, 1.5 cups, and then we're just gonna keep stirring it, and as soon as that liquid is absorbed, we're just gonna add another 1.5 cups.
Of that?
Yep, okay. Of the chicken stock. Perfect.
Right.
So here, Jillian, I have my salad.
I know.
So simple, so quick, right? I mean,
yeah.
You didn't even know I was doing it.
No.
I just have simple mixed greens. I've cubed up 1 pear and about 1/2 cup of blue cheese.
Okay.
Now here, you might want to take note of this. All I did was I added 1/4 cup of balsamic vinegar.
Okay.
And now I've added 1/2 cup of olive oil. I'm just going to whisk that up.
Add 1 tablespoon of honey and salt and pepper to taste.
Okay, so at the grocery store, we just bought 2 filet mignons. Just go to your butcher and say, I need filet for 2 people.
Okay.
He's got you.
Okay.
Same thing, you're gonna go to your seafood department and you're just gonna ask for peeled and deveined shrimp.
Peeled and deveined?
deveined. So you want the vein.
Oh, deveined.
Yep, you want the vein out of it because okay. You just don't want to deal with that. It's not necessary.
Right.
Great, so what you're going to do is add 2 pinches of salt and pepper to both sides of the fillet and the shrimp.
Okay.
Great. Okay, so Jillian, our risotto has absorbed all of the chicken stock and it's ready for the red wine.
Yeah.
We have 1 cup of a dry red wine. You can use any of your favorite brand. You just want to make sure that the taste is good enough that you would drink it, because the taste is what's going to be evaporated once the liquid goes away.
Ready?
Great, so go ahead and add that.
Ooh,
and that's what's going to give us our beautiful, beautiful Valentine's Day color, right?
Yeah.
It looks awesome. So just go ahead and stir that in. Meanwhile, I'm going to get our mushrooms going, which we're going to add to our risotto. So I have 2 tablespoons of melted butter here. I'm going to add 1 pound of thinly sliced mushrooms. So you're just going to slice them fairly thinly, add them into the butter. Okay, so our risotto has absorbed the red wine, right? It looks really, really good and it smells awesome in
delicious.
Here. So our mushrooms are ready to go. All we did was saute those for about 5 minutes in the 2 tablespoons of butter, a little salt and pepper, and they're ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just gonna add those in, and can you just fold those in for me?
Yep.
Perfect. It looks so good. So let's turn the heat off of our risotto, cover it, and start our protein. The last step. So Jillian, our risotto is setting off to the side. It's just gonna keep absorbing a little bit of that last wine.
Cool.
So it's set to go, you're done. Last step is the protein.
Okay.
You're gonna be in charge of the shrimp, okay?
All right.
So what we have in our pan here is we have 2 tablespoons of butter in each, okay? So you're just gonna go ahead and add your shrimp. I'll let you have that. Meanwhile, I'm gonna add my steak. Okay, so. The worst thing that you could do after all this hard work is overcook your protein, right?
Yeah.
Trick is, ready?
Yeah.
So the shrimp is gonna go on, the steak is gonna go on at the same time,
okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So the shrimp is gonna cook for 2 minutes on each side,
okay.
And the beef is gonna cook for 4 minutes on each side, giving you a perfectly cooked shrimp and a perfectly cooked medium rare steak. So our shrimp are pink, they've cooked 2 minutes on both sides. We're gonna add a tablespoon of red pepper flakes to give them a really nice pungent kick. Go ahead, Jillian. Awesome, so give that a quick stir.
Okay.
Great. And we're just gonna add another 1/2 tablespoon of butter.
Okay,
so our proteins are resting. We're gonna let them rest for about 2 minutes just so that everything can kind of soak in and get ready for eating. Now, what we have here in the same pan that we cooked the steak, we added 1/2 cup of balsamic vinegar. Now, we're gonna let this reduce until it becomes nice and thick. Make sure that you scrape from the bottom of the pan to get all those delicious juices from the steak. As soon as your balsamic vinegar has reduced by half, go ahead and add 2 tablespoons of butter, which is gonna give it an extra creaminess that's gonna be absolutely delicious. So Jillian, we did it.
We did it.
I am so proud of you. You did an awesome job.
Oh, thank you.
And it wasn't that hard.
No.
I mean, you can totally do this on Valentine's Day.
Yeah, yep. I think I really can.
Yep, I can't wait to hear all about it. I know that he is just gonna be totally floored.
Yeah.
All right, well we gotta go dig in.
Okay.
But make sure to join us next time on Plan Your Dinner. Cheers.